Hey guys, and welcome back to the channel and to another rockpooling video, where today you find me at Hollicombe Beach in Torbay, a place where many amazing sea creatures can be found in the rockpools. So let's not waste any time and let me show you all of the awesome species I managed to find. The first find of this rockpooling trip was this green sea urchin, which was one of many found during this trip. I actually ended up finding one under almost every rock I flipped over. One of the best things about this beach is that there is so much life under every rock you flip over. How many different species can you spot in this clip? The most common crab species I encountered during this trip was the common shore crab, and interestingly, most individuals that I found only had one claw. The water clarity wasn't the best during this rockpooling trip, but some rockpools like this one in this clip were fairly clear. There were also a lot of large strawberry anemones scattered around the rockpools of this beach. It was great to find a few worm pipefish in the rock pools during this trip, as this is one of my favourite fish species to find while rock pooling. As you can see from this clip, Hollicombe Beach is actually very similar to my local beaches of Coriton Cove and Langstone Rock, including the rock formations and type of sediment. However, I've come across a few species at this beach that I've never found at my local beaches, including some that you'll see later in this video. One species that I find at almost every beach I visit is the invasive wireweed. Another one of my favourite species to find while rockpooling is the snakelocks anemone. We are very lucky to have such a vibrant species that is native to UK waters. This species also has a secondary coloration, a much less vibrant grey and brown coloration, but they're still cool to see. I wasn't expecting to find a cushion starfish while rock pooling at this beach, as I rarely ever find them on sandy beaches like this one, so it was nice to see. I noticed that there was a lot of juvenile shannies in the rock pools during this trip, but I was expecting to find a few of them, as this is the most common fish species that you can find in UK rock pools. I also managed to find a different fish species shortly after finding the shannies. This is a Montagu's blenny, which can be easily identified by the crest on its head, as well as bright blue spots on its face and body. At this point in the rock pooling trip, I decided to flip over a few more rocks to see what I could find. I ended up finding a wide variety of species under these rocks, including edible crabs, green sea urchins, worm pipefish, and much more. I also managed to find a large velvet swimming crab. This species of crab is definitely one of my favourite crab species, as I love their bright red eyes and aggressive behaviour, which was actually the subject of my dissertation for my marine biology degree. Another crab I came across often was the broad-clawed porcelain crab. This species can often be found on sandy beaches around the UK. This species also has some great camouflage, which makes them hard to spot sometimes. One species I found frequently underneath rocks on this beach was the red ripple bryozoan, which is a species that I've never featured on the channel before, so this was another great find. Another interesting find was this dead compass jellyfish, which is only the second jellyfish I've seen this year, so it was cool to see, but it's unfortunate that this individual wasn't alive. There were also a lot of colourful sea sponges in and around the rock pools of this beach. As I moved up towards the upper shore, I noticed that there was a lot of different sea snail species on this particular area of the shore, including the colourful purple topshell. I also managed to find various groups of dog whelk eggs under rocks and in cracks and crevices on the beach. Hollicombe Beach is completely dominated by barnacles, including the Volcano barnacle. Here you can see just how many barnacles are living on this beach. This entire area of rock is completely covered in them. Another interesting find was this juvenile shore crab with a bright red coloration. There was lots to see washed up on this area of the shore, including cuttlefish bones, spider crab shells, and lobster claws. The final find of this rock pooling trip was a group of seabirds foraging for food on the shore. I believe these are turnstones, which I've only found a few times in the past, so it was great to see them again. So, that's all for today's rock pooling video. If you enjoyed this video and learned something new, please leave a like and remember to subscribe to see more rock pooling videos on my channel in the future. Thank you for watching, and I will see you in the next video.